So away we go. Men's singles. There's a
elegant in his attack. You, as you mentioned, playing on home soil and coming off. Rely on the initiative on the front court here. He needs to register what kind of playing conditions is it that we have here in Glass Arena. In Ren, is he playing the fast side? Perhaps that's definitely one of the questions that he'll ask himself. Didn't look like he was applying too much power, Srikanth. Attacking player, so he should have an advantage against an average player. A bit slower playing conditions would have suited him well. Oi! See, the little deception gives Srikanth the initiative. All his second men singles on that occasion. To leave that a little bit open and focus on challenging Srikanth on the front court.
Well. Wait.
Hey, the rally is going on, but the umpire is not the correct term. So, Popov gets a second chance in this round. Since then, fast. That's an amazing lift. Excellent.
There's a glimmer here, 15-13.
Oi!
Yeah, we can.
interception. Also well defended by Popov. I think we'll see him in some of the style we see here, where he's trying to make the court big for Toma Popov. I'm feeling that if there is any drift, then he's trying to. Then Srikanth is playing up against it. For Srikanth to play the back line with quality. To the back line. Second game is sightline errors from the Indian. Brilliant.
Three having won the first game. Fairly quickly.
There's a little twist in this, not necessarily this match for Toma Popov. 100 points, that's the difference between them. Back in front as the highest ranked French player in the Olympic qualification. They also play men's doubles.
There's Toma.
And if you're an attacking player and go on a roll, then you can score quick points in succession.
Yeah, he'd be right back in business. Late decision to play that.
Yeah. It's gone long. Yeah. Wait, it's gone long. No, stays in. Good deception. That one went long. The Stade Pierre de Coubertin in Paris. Questions asked by Srikanth.